Let us study about a voltmeter, about which you already have studied some basics, that for a voltmeter we can write it is used to measure potential difference across two points in a circuit. So, for measurement, we can again write further that for measurement of potential difference in a circuit, this voltmeter is connected in parallel across the points where potential difference is to be measured. The point across which we wish to measure the potential difference, we connect the given voltmeter in parallel combination so that its reading can be taken. We can also state that for an ideal voltmeter, its internal resistance must be infinite, because whenever a device is connected in parallel, if its internal resistance is zero, the circuit will be short circuited and the whole current will pass through the device and the circuit will not contain any current so that the potential difference can be measured. So, in this situation, a voltmeter will be ideal only if its resistance is infinite, so that it will not extract any current from the circuit. Or in lab voltmeters, we can say its resistance will be very, very large, because practically it can never be infinite. We can also that add that for an ideal voltmeter, its internal resistance must be infinite, so that it will not draw any current from circuit. Because a voltmeter will draw some current from the circuit current decreases and hence its potential difference which we are going to measure will also alter. So, in lab voltmeters we can say there exists some high resistance because of which it draws some minute current which will alter slightly the potential difference which we are measuring by using the voltmeter. And about a voltmeter we can write that it is constructed by connecting a high resistance in series with the galvanometer of appropriate value. This appropriate value I have written for this high resistance. When an appropriate value high resistance is connected in series with the galvanometer, it can be used as a voltmeter. A typical voltmeter, here you can see in this situation, which when connected across a potential difference or a battery and if the switch is closed, it draws a minute current, very low value of current it draws, and due to which the needle is deflected up to the value of potential difference which we are willing to measure. So, this is the way how the voltmeter is used to measure potential differences. We will also discuss some specific kind of circuits in which we will see how a voltmeter can be used for potential difference measurement.